beautiful little unicorns, and welcome back to my channel. If this is indeed the first time that you're on my channel, my name is Vanessa Samina, and I would like to welcome you into the fam. And if this is the first time that you've discovered this part of YouTube and my channel, then make sure that you don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on your notification bell. I have not left my subscribers without a monthly horoscope in years, so you know that you can count on me. Because the Unicorn Queen is a consistent queen, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the month of October, and I am beyond excited for you to receive yours. So allow me to explain to you how this video works. So to start off your October predictions, you get to pick one of these four groups in order to receive the first part of your October prediction. And once you have received the first part of your reading, which corresponds to one of these four groups, you get to scroll down into the description box or into the comment section where I have pinned all of the timestamps of each sign of the zodiac. So you can then click your zodiac sign and you'll be fast forwarded to the relevant part of the video. And just as a little disclaimer, I am using the tropical astrology system, and I would highly recommend that you watch your sun, moon, and rising signs prediction. That way you can ensure that your October prediction is as personal and accurate as it can possibly be. So please allow me to introduce you to the four groups that I have prepared for you for the first part of your reading. Group number one corresponds to the tiger's eye. Group number two corresponds to the amethyst. Group number three corresponds to the orchid calcite, and group number four corresponds to the black tourmaline. So I would highly recommend that you pick whichever crystal that you feel naturally drawn towards and that you feel represents you. I will also provide you with a little moment of privacy to meditate on the four groups. Feel free to pause the video right here if you need to, in order to feel confident in your choice for the first part of your October reading. So by now, you've hopefully been able to pick one of these four groups in order to receive the first part of your reading. I will be starting off your readings with the first group, which corresponds to the tiger's eye crystal. So if this is the group that you chose, you can keep watching. And to all of my other lovely groups, as well as signs of the zodiac, I will catch you at the click of your timestamp. Hello, group number one, and welcome to your reading. So you chose the tiger eye crystal to help guide you through the month of October and to help uncover the messages that we have present for you. So we have simplicity, love, as well as transformation. So group number one, I can see here that October is going to be a very straightforward month for you. It's not going to be a month with a lot of secrets or a lot of mysteries. I can see in simplicity as well as love, that this straightforward energy is definitely something that is bringing out a lot of caring vibration, a lot of healing energy that in the end is going to lead to some sort of transformation in you and your surroundings. So because there is an increased amount of love in your life during the month of October, you will find that things just work out way more easily than usual. That's why we have the message of simplicity within your reading, and just overall things seem to flow so easily, and that too helps with the transformation going smoothly for you in October. Next we have the mountain goat. In the mountain goat, I can see that something is out of balance that is coming back into balance, which is why you are going through this transformation, group number one. And I can see here that you are doing whatever you need to in order to correct it during the month of October. So October is definitely kind of a bit of a corrective month for you, group number one. And it's a month in which you're going to fix any type of difficulties or any hurdles that otherwise may have held you back. In the boar, also known as the pig, I can see here that you're facing your problems head on. You're fearless, you're full of confidence as well as courage, and I can see here that you will emerge in a victorious way. The boar is definitely a symbol of good luck, good fortune, group number one, and this is something that I want you to look forward to and that I definitely want you to celebrate for the month of October. So things are already looking up for you for October. I'm also really excited to figure out what your zodiac sign says about what October will be like for you. But let's move a little further into this first part part of your reading, shall we? We have a new earth. I can see here that something is happening and you are meant to keep holding the vision. And with something happening, we spoke about this transformation taking place for you, group number one. That is what's happening. That is what October is about for you. Hold the vision of who you want to be once a transformation has taken place, once a transformation has been completed. So definitely hold your vision for October, November, December, and throughout 2022, the next upcoming year. Hold the vision of how you would like your life to change for the better and who you would like to become as a person, as that will help propel you to that point way more easily than if you just blindly manifest without holding a vision before you. We have another card that popped out of the pile a little clumsily, but the card is You've Got the Love. We have codependency as well as boundaries that the universe wants to speak to you about, group number one. So it's very important here throughout this transformation that you're experiencing in October to not allow codependency to come in between you and the forward movement that is taking place. Yes, codependency is something that can get in the way of you and your progression, that can get in the way of you and your personal development, which is why it's so important for you to sever ties during the month of October from anyone who gives you confidence to do things in a way that isn't healthy. Like, for example, if you can't go out by yourself, be it to grocery shop or just to go somewhere to do something fun, and you have that person that you are a little bit codependent on, definitely sever ties with them for the month. Of course, don't do it in a hurtful way. Tell them that you're trying to do more things by yourself and you're trying to gain more confidence in doing things alone. Let them know what's going on, but definitely create some boundaries there and make sure that codependency isn't something that is in fact holding you back. We have a lifting the veil. You're questioning everything, group number one. That's one thing that I can see here within lifting the veil, and that anything that isn't aligned with you must go. So you are definitely not looking at things from lovey-dovey perspectives, from rose-colored glasses. I can definitely see in lifting the veil that you want the truth, you want honesty, and I'm so excited that you're here for it, group number one, because I am extremely honest, especially when I do each zodiac sign later on within this video. So I hope you're looking forward to a very honest October prediction and lifting the veil on what's coming for you. But I can definitely see that anything that comes your way, you're fine with it, and you would rather be hurt by the truth than comforted with a lie and then later on find out the truth anyways. I can see here within diligence that you emerging from October confidently and victoriously is definitely also because you are so diligent, because you are so hell-bent on making the things that you desire work, and you're not going to let anyone or anything come in between you and what you desire and what you've been looking forward to accomplishing. I can see here within power, group number one, that the month of October is going to show you just how much personal power that you really possess and how much personal power that you've maybe not even known of, that you've maybe been ignoring, not purposely, but without knowing that you have a lot more in you that can lead to change and amazing transformation. You've kind of been focused on making yourself smaller than you need to, but I see that changing for October. We have the Devil next, group number one. And now the Devil is a card that is kind of bittersweet, because on one side we have definitely a little bit of a scary notion, someone tempting you into something that you know you maybe shouldn't be engaging in, but the Devil definitely also stands for temptation in a sensual manner, in a manner of you being physically close with another person. And there may be a bit of a player. Maybe you are also not looking for any type of commitment with this person. You're just trying to see where it goes, and that's okay. Don't vilify yourself because of that. We are all entitled to experiencing our bodies however we would like to experience them. I can see in the Ten of Cups that that is actually leading to happiness, that is actually leading to fulfillment when you can simply enjoy your body however you please. That is definitely what makes you feel the most at home, the most comfortable, and will give you the best experience possible. The Empress reverse shows me that there is no childlike type of topic in October for you, okay? Fertility is not something that you need to worry about and is definitely not something that is even on the table for you. You're not thinking about offspring, you're not thinking about growing your family. You're kind of more about figuring yourself out and enjoying any physical experience that you're able to have during the month of October. I can see here within the Bay that you are growing significantly in wisdom, group number one, and in the Cucumber, I can see that you are very selective with your emotions. You're not just going to show anyone how you feel or what you're going through. You're ensuring that anyone who you share your deepest, darkest secrets and your emotions with is really worthy and isn't just someone who you're having a little bit of fun with. So you're making a distinct difference between people who are here to stay and people who you're just having fun with. And that's fine. And that's something that I don't want you to judge yourself by, and instead simply enjoy October and all of the freedom that this month is bringing you, and the simplicity, the love, the personal transformation. So group number one, this is the first part of your October prediction that I have received for you, and I truly hope you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section by leaving a pig emoji right down there to let me and others know that you made it to the end. Now hop on down into the description box and into the comment section, whichever works for you. I have the timestamps of all of the zodiac signs pinned in both areas, so you can click your zodiac sign and you'll be fast forwarded to your zodiac signs part two of your October prediction. So I'll catch you over there. Hello, group number two, and welcome to the first part of your October prediction. So you chose the Amethyst to help guide you through the month of October and to help uncover the messages that you need to receive for your October prediction. So first up, we have truth, taking risks, as well as fulfillment. So group number two, I can see here that October is going to be filled with truth bombs. It's going to be filled with you uncovering a lot of information that has remained hidden for a while but needs to come to light during the month of October. I can see here within taking risks that, of course, this is going to feel like a bit of a risk because these truth bombs have a lot to do with things that you have already had a gut feeling about for a long time. So a feeling that someone has maybe been dishonest with you, that maybe someone has been lying to you or telling you half truths all this time. So in taking risks, I can definitely see that it's not going to be easy for you to decide to get to the bottom of things and to uncover some truths that are available for you to figure out finally during the month of October. But I can see here within fulfillment that at the end of the day, you're going to be happy that you received the truth. You would rather know the truth than be comforted by a lie, group number two. That is one thing that I can see immediately within your reading and in the type of person that you are. So truth coming to light is a positive thing for you in October, even if the truth isn't the easiest to digest. I can see here with the messenger that you are bringing harmony and balance into your life through kind of uncovering anything that has remained veiled for a long time. So any piece of information that you have wanted to know for sure in the past weeks, months, or maybe even years, I can see that uncovering all of those hidden messages, that's going to make you feel like you can just relax and you are going to know that the messenger or the person who is bringing you the truth is definitely not always to blame or very seldom to blame, and you're going to approach October in a very mature way. I can see here within water, your garden, that nourishing yourself and body care is very important to you, especially during October. With everything that's going on an emotional basis and you uncovering so much truth that you didn't expect, tenderness, rest, body care, all of those things serve you so well, group number two. And all of those things are so important for you to prioritize and to engage in. So also make sure you pamper yourself in any way you can. If you can get some sort of body treatment done, do that. If you would like a version of that that is a little bit more affordable, then you can even make your own body scrubs. You can run yourself a beautiful bath. You can give yourself a massage with some organic coconut oil that you maybe just have lying around at home. The different ways in which you can comfort yourself and nourish your soul and your body, those ways are endless. And also doing lots of home cooked meals with really high quality ingredients instead of eating out, that's another great way that you can nourish yourself in October. I see here within the Ace of Crystals that there are lots of fun ideas that are coming to you in October that make you feel like taking some risks. So it's almost like gambling. It's almost like these fun, exciting ideas, they may go right, they may go left, but either way, you're here for it and you're here to experience something new. I can see here within the Two of Crystals that all of the ideas that work out, so maybe you have an idea of creating music, of doing some art, of maybe trying something new with your physical body, some new yoga poses, some new gymnastics type things, pushing your body to its limit. You're going to take whatever has worked out for you with you, and whatever doesn't work out, you're going to leave behind. I see that in the Two of Crystals, and that's a really healthy way to approach things, especially when you have new ideas and you're trying out new hobbies, group number two, because the less pressure that you put on being perfect and the less pressure that you put on nailing everything the first time you try, the less you are going to get frustrated or feel embarrassed or feel like you're not doing well enough, and the more you'll actually be able to just take with you what truly serves you. I can see within the Seven of Crystals, wow, we actually have so much fire sign energy because the Ace of Crystals corresponds to the element of fire. So does the Two of Crystals and the Seven of Crystals, because the Suit of Crystals is actually the suit that connects to the element of fire. And this is the tarot deck that I authored for any of you who are maybe wondering, and the suit being crystals was a conscious choice of mine to use for the element of fire. The Seven of Crystals does show me here that you may find some opposing forces that you have to stand up to. So these opposing forces may be, for example, a boss, co-workers, parents who don't quite agree with your approach to life or what you're doing. And I can see here in the Nine of Crystals, again, crystals, we have so much fire sign energy, so much Leo, Sagittarius, and Aries energy. I see that you're fed up with that, you're done with it, and you, quite frankly speaking, just want to move on from unsolicited advice after October, because there's no point for you. It doesn't serve anyone. It doesn't serve any greater purpose. The Nine of Crystals definitely shows me that you're distancing yourself from people who give too much unsolicited advice. The Three of Crystals, I mean, what are the odds, group number two? There are 78 cards in this deck. 14 of these cards correspond to the Suit of Crystals, okay? Just 14 cards out of the 78. Every single one of the tarot cards that I have pulled for you that have been propelled into your October prediction have been of the Suit of Crystals. And I mean, you've seen me shuffle the deck. We've been using it throughout the reading. We've been shuffling, we've been intuitively laying. Now we got the Three of Crystals. So for some reason, you are super connected to the element of fire during the month of October. And the element of fire definitely brings out a side of you that is ambitious, that wants to get things done, that is very much into forward moving, thinking ahead, and has that phallic energy. For any of you who don't know, group two, phallic energy is masculine energy, because also the Suit of Crystals corresponds to a phallic symbol, right? A masculine symbol. The Three of Crystals definitely does also show here that you are going to make decisions to leave people behind, not only those people who have unsolicited advice for you, but also people who just overall have not been there for you in a long time. So you're deleting varying numbers of people who you haven't spoken to in forever, and you're kind of ensuring that you're clearing out your energetic space and only keeping the people who are really meaningful to you. In the Lemurian courts, I see that practicing patience is what you're going to need to kind of balance yourself out, group number two, because with all of this fire sign energy comes a lot of force, comes a lot of taking action and taking risks, maybe too many risks, maybe even being a little bit reckless. So be patient and try not to get in over your head about doing certain things that you're maybe feeling impatient about. I can see within the rainbow obsidian that healing your heart is another thing you're engaged in during the month of October. Healing your heart through taking action, that's a real thing. You can heal your heart through keeping yourself busy, is what I meant to say, and through ensuring that you're never in a state of sadness and grief all by yourself alone, where you feel like you're just overcome by heavy emotions. So I can definitely see that there are a lot of crystals here because you're also trying to kind of avoid standing still and having to face maybe even certain traumas, childhood traumas that may resurface during the month of October. I can see within broccoli that you're all about taking the lead, you're all about moving into a leadership position, and this definitely resonates really well with your fire sign energy that is present here for October for you, because this fire sign energy is that type of leadership energy that brings innovation and force to the table. So you definitely have a very mature type of CEO energy about you during the month of October. So making big decisions and also putting yourself at the forefront of a corporation or of your own business, really delivering what you have promised. That is what I see coming for you. In the apple, there is continuance of this leadership that is ahead as well. So continuance meaning that even past the month of October, group number two, you will continue to find comfort in kind of exerting this leader energy that you've always had within you, that maybe at some point you were a little bit too afraid to actually embrace. But in the apple, I see that that's going to continue to move on. The stock shows me that you are super focused, group two. There is nothing that can take your focus away from the things that you've set your mind on and the things that you truly feel are important to you. And it's great for you to be so goal-oriented, and it's definitely something that reflects within your reading that just shows what type of energy that you're on during the month of October. You're not tolerating any BS. You're not tolerating anyone wasting your time. You're definitely all about your grind and your bag. Then we have focus as well as community. You're definitely focused on giving back to your community as well. So while you're cutting ties or severing ties with some people who simply don't bring anything to the table for you anymore, you are definitely focused on creating value for your community and for those who are coming after you. So you want to set a great example. You want to be a pillar of light in your community. You want to give back to those who are less fortunate. And the fact that you're putting your energy into that, group number two, that's something really beautiful and something to be proud of. And it's a great way for you to use some of this phallic masculine energy that you have overflowing within you in October, as we spoke about here within all of these cards that correspond to the element of crystals. Literally every single, the element of fire, excuse me, the suit of crystals is what I meant to say. Literally every tarot card that I pulled for you, all the other cards are oracle cards, just for your information. Every single tarot card that we pulled was a card that corresponded to fire signs. So definitely know that this is the type of energy you're exerting. Even if you're not a fire sign, this is something that resonates greatly with you. So group two, and make sure that you leave a flame emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you were here, that you received the first part of your reading, and that it hit home, that it resonated with you. Now scroll on down into the description box, as well as into the comment section, where I have each zodiac sign's timestamp listed. So all you need to do is click the timestamp that corresponds to your zodiac sign in order to receive the second and even more accurate part of your October prediction. So I'll catch you over during your zodiac signs reading. Hello, group number three, and welcome to your reading. So you chose the Orchid Calcite to help guide you through the month of October and to help deliver the relevant messages that you are meant to receive. So let's move straight into your reading, shall we? First up, we have stillness, solitude, and relaxation. So group number three, I can definitely see here that October is going to be a month of stillness, of you chilling, of you relaxing, and of spending a lot of time to yourself, recharging, giving yourself the time and self-care that you've needed for so long. I can see within stillness that you're definitely also going to pick meditation back up, or yoga, just some sort of practice that allows you to immerse yourself in nothing and just being still and being in the moment and not having to worry or care about emails, about text messages, about any type of projects that you have going on, group number three. You're definitely rebalancing yourself, regaining your strength during the month of October. And this is a month where it is so essential for you to take that time to recharge, as November and December are most likely going to be a little crazy for you. I can see here within protection that you are protecting your inner peace, you are protecting yourself. That is why you're taking so much time to relax and you're taking so much time for stillness and solitude. When you are around other people too much, because you're such a sensitive person, you're almost like a porous stone, like a porous crystal that absorbs anything around it. You absorb other people's energy, you absorb other people's vibration very easily, and it affects you. So there's a reason why you're taking time away, why you're spending time in solitude, because you just need to cleanse yourself and rid yourself of everyone else's energy, everyone else's issues, and simply just be you, group number three. And I totally get that. I totally understand it. As a water sign especially, I feel like this is something that just hits home so much and that you have to be so careful with. But no matter what sign that you are, group number three, I can definitely see here within stillness, solitude, relaxation, and protection that you're literally just protecting yourself, you're protecting your energy, and you're not granting people access to you so easily during the month of October. I see here in the King of Diamonds that a lot of it also has to do with you just getting your head and yourself really focused on what you want in your career and in the earthly realms. So really staying on your grind, really making sure that you are making smart business moves and that you're being the person that you've always wanted to be financially and in the earthly realms, that you are making amazing moves in your career that you can be proud of. And in the King of Diamonds, I see that the only way you can do that is by taking a little bit of space and distance from other people. And after all, also, every single person has different aspirations when it comes to their career, and everyone does business differently, and you're trying to also distance yourself from other people's ways of doing business, other people's ways of going through life, because you have your own very unique way of doing things. I can see here within judgment that for you, it's definitely also all about ensuring that you are protecting your energy from people who judge, from people who are maybe a little bit more mundane, from people who don't understand your way of life or don't want to understand your way of life, and therefore are giving you energy that almost makes you feel ashamed. You know, when you're around people who are very much like cookie cutter, copy and paste, that kind of crowd, it can be hard to stand out or to be different, and that is not like to judge them. That is more like a sign of your own insecurity around those types of people, and sometimes just distancing yourself from them and reminding yourself of who the F you are is all that you need, group number three, in order to get yourself back to a place of confidence where you're not blaming others for making you feel kind of self-conscious, but you are admitting to yourself that, hey, maybe I just need to amp up my confidence. Maybe I just haven't been where I need to be when it comes to my belief in myself and my abilities. The Knight of Crystals shows me here that you're going for things financially. You're going for business deals. You're going for anything that you can in order to propel your career forward. The Three of Cups reversed shows me that rather than spending too much time partying, you're definitely very inclined to spend a lot of time in your career. But keep in mind, group three, balance is key. Don't just spend all of your free time working or all of your free time just encompassed in your career. Definitely make sure that you have some balance and that you spend a lot of time relaxing and recuperating. Sleep is something that a lot of people really underestimate its value of. Sleep is one of the most important things for human beings and also lots of animals. Just think about it. In evolution, we have cut out so many unnecessary things, but sleep has always remained, and sleep is something that is actually so dangerous for humans to do. And I read that in the Why We Sleep book by Matthew Walker. That is like a book I would so highly recommend, group number three. So if you're looking for a book about sleep that really hits home, read that book. And one paragraph, one section was all about how in evolution, just imagine how dangerous it actually is to sleep. You are out for 8 hours, 6 hours, however many hours a full night's sleep is for an average human being. Even if you're a short sleeper, that's maybe what, 6 hours, 5 hours? And very few people are real short sleepers. Most of us need like 8 hours a night. You're completely out. A predator could get you. A predator could go for your throat, could go for your jugular, group number three. But for some reason, sleep is so important that evolution didn't rule it out, and that evolution still made us need sleep, still made us be passed out every single night in order to function properly, even if that exposes us to lots of other dangers. Now, just imagine how dangerous it is not to sleep, for the fact that sleep is something that we have retained as human beings that is necessary to survive. Next up, we have the Page of Swords. So in the Page of Swords, I can see here that you're highly intellectual, just generally speaking, group number three, but during the month of October, reading lots of books is most likely something that you will be engaged in. I can also see here in relaxation that just laying back, reading blogs, books, some sort of educational material being taken in by you is a big part of October. So the Why We Sleep book is definitely a recommendation that I would say you should read in October. It will completely change the way you feel about sleeping. The King of Cups does show me here that you are in control of your emotions because of how much rest and relaxation that you're getting. You don't get hung up on other people's comments or other people's moods. It doesn't really bother you. You know your value and your worth, and you're very unbothered because you feel well rested. The Hanged Man also shows me again that you are happy with where you are in October. You're okay with being complacent for a month. It's actually not even being complacent. You recuperating and gaining strength, truly relaxing, is going to serve you so much more in the long term, because there is no human being that can constantly work and constantly be productive and effective 365 days a year for like decades on end. It's not possible. We all need recuperation, and you're taking that seriously, and it's definitely going to serve you. I can see here within the Lovers reverse that will leave a little bit less time for romance, but nevertheless, romance is present for you, group number three, and it's not something that's missing, quite the contrary. You're actually spending a good amount of time with a romantic interest or romantic partner during the month of October. I can see here in the Dog that your loyalty and faithfulness can be misplaced by trying to serve too many people, which is what you're realizing. And especially as an introvert, as someone who is able to regain a lot of their strength through being alone rather than be able to fill up their tank with other people, you will realize here that giving too many people the benefit of the doubt, or just trying to spend too much time with too many different groups of people, too many different individuals, can feel very draining. So it's essential for you to pick out the people who recharge you, with who you feel your loyalty and faithfulness are safe, and who you feel definitely give you that same energy back. Then next up, we have the Mountain Goat. In the Mountain Goat, I can see here that the reason why you're spending so much time resting, sleeping, and recuperating is because you were definitely knocked out of homeostasis. That means being knocked out of balance, knocked out of your personal equilibrium, your personal center. And I can see here in the mountain goat that you're doing whatever you need to correct that. You're not allowing the scale to be tipped completely to one side because you know it doesn't serve you in the long run anyways. So you might as well spend the necessary time taking care of yourself physically as well as emotionally. And I'm really proud of you for doing this. Group number three, it shows a lot of maturity. It shows that you truly respect yourself, your body, and your soul, and that you're on the right track. Now, group three, this is the first part of your reading that I received for you. If you enjoyed it, make sure you leave a swan emoji down below, also to let me and others know that this is the group that you chose and that you made it to the end. And furthermore, the timestamps for the second part of your October prediction, those can all be found down below as well for each and every zodiac sign. So once you click your zodiac sign, you will be fast forwarded to the relevant part of your reading, and I'll catch you during part two of your October prediction, where we're going to get even more into detail about what's coming for you in the upcoming month. So I'll catch you over there. Hello, group number four, and welcome to the first part of your October prediction. You chose the black tourmaline to help figure out exactly what's coming towards you during the month of October. So let's get straight into it, shall we? We have wisdom, enlightenment, and potential. So group number four, I can definitely see here that October is filled with epiphanies, with enlightenment, as well as a potential big spiritual awakening. And I can see here in potential that there's so much that lies before you in October that you can make use of and with which you can grow your wisdom, group number four. That is one thing that I can see so far within your reading for October. So this is a month full of potential prosperity. This is a month full of potential for you to grow and to evolve as a being. I can see here with an opportunity that the universe is just trying to ensure that you 100% understand how fortunate that you are to be in the position that you're in October, with so much potential and opportunity that lies ahead of you. So October is just one of those months where you can change your entire life in 1 month's time, compared to maybe spending months and months on end working on a project and getting nowhere. So October is just one of those times in your life where you are able to move forward very rapidly, grow as a person, as well as advance in your life like you haven't done in a very long time. If you've ever had one of those ultra productive days, weeks, or months where all of a sudden you accomplish way more in like 1 month than you've accomplished in the entire year, that's what October is going to be like for you, group number four. Next up, we have the Temperance card. So in Temperance, I can see here that because things are moving forward so swiftly and rapidly, you may feel kind of inclined to do everything at once, which is why it's important for you to also take a little bit of a step back in between in October and make sure that you're sleeping enough, make sure that you're nourishing your body appropriately, and ensure that you're not spending all of your time and energy just in this space of potential and opportunity and trying to spread yourself too thin too quickly and too frequently. The Six of Diamonds reverse definitely shows me here that some people are going to want a piece of your cake, group number four. And by that, I mean a lot of people are going to notice how October is a very important month in your life. And you're doing a lot of great things. Some people may be a little bit jealous, whereas some people kind of want to know what your secret is, group number four, which is why it's important for you here in the Six of Diamonds to not give anyone too much of your money, time, energy, or effort who you have this lingering feeling will maybe not return the favor, okay? So no new friends in October, as a lot of wise musicians have said before in their songs. Just stick to the OGs, to the people who you know that you can count on when you need them as well. I can see here in the Empress reverse that when it comes to fertility, when it comes to family, there are no new add-ons. There's nothing happening there when it comes to growing your family or even thinking of adding into your family because you're solely focused on your epiphanies, on your wisdom, on your potential and your opportunities that you have before you. The Page of Swords, it definitely shows me here that because there's so much going on for you, you feel like you're a completely new person mentally. So while physically not that much is changing for you in October, group number four, just mentally you're completely different. You're a completely newly rewired version of yourself, and that in turn may actually change how you see yourself physically. So you will grow more accepting of your flaws, more accepting of the fact that you are not a perfect doll, you're a human being, and you're meant to have flaws, and you're meant to have pores and uneven eyebrows and just areas of your body that you don't like. I mean, whatever it is that bothers you, definitely know here that you're growing a lot more accepting of it. The banana shows me that there is a duality present that you appreciate. And with duality, I mean understanding that on one hand, you can have flaws and things you don't like about yourself. And at the same time, you can also have lots of parts of yourself that you truly love. You can have a masculine side that pushes things forward that can be assertive and aggressive, but you can also have a very nurturing feminine side without necessarily wanting to venture straight into children or venture straight into nurturing other beings. Maybe you just want to keep that nurturing energy for yourself. I can see here within the bay that just overall you're growing so much in wisdom and so much in acceptance and understanding of yourself and who you are as a human being that you will just most likely not even recognize yourself after the month of October has passed by because of all of the changes that are occurring for you mentally is what I meant to say. Group number four, I'm just so excited about your reading and everything that's going on. I'm kind of getting ahead of it a little bit. I can see here within the cucumber that this will spark lots of emotion of joy, lots of emotion of feeling like you finally made it. You're finally in a place in your life where you're happy with yourself, and the potato shows me very grounded energy that is being exerted from you. So this grounding energy is coming from a place of just feeling deeply rooted in yourself, feeling deeply rooted in your purpose, and understanding that you've arrived at a place of inner peace and acceptance of all of your exterior and interior flaws as well. New beginnings, that kind of goes without say. We've just been talking about that group number four, how October is like a fresh chapter, it's like a new month, and of course it's going to be a new beginning for you. It's going to be a time of finally feeling as though you can start things on a fresh slate, and you can be best friends with your body, your mind, and your soul, and you no longer need to pick yourself apart. The Five of Bottles does show me here that some people are not going to agree with it. Some people are not going to like that. I can see that in the Five of Bottles in connection to the new beginnings, okay? Some relationships are not going to be able to survive these changes and these spiritual enlightenments that you're going through, and that's okay. Some friends and family are just meant to be tight with you for a certain period of your life or a certain chapter in your life. Not everyone is meant to thrive with you through every single change in your life, and vice versa. The Four of Bottles definitely shows me here that it's okay for you to like cut people off. You may feel a little bit bad for it, group number four, because it's just not your intention, it's never your purpose, but when you're just not vibing with someone or a situation, I mean, you can't pretend that you are right. Energy doesn't lie. I can see here within the Hierophant that energetic exchanges are becoming more and more important to you. So it's not so much about what people say, it's more about how they say it, it's more about how people make you feel. And after encounters with people, you ask yourself, did this fill me up? Do I now feel better about myself? Do I now feel like my energy has been replenished? Or do I feel like my energy has been drained? And these are questions that I've been asking myself a lot. If you guys follow me on Instagram, then you know I'm always posting different quotes about these types of things and thinking about these types of things, that it's so important for us to not just think about what type of value or wisdom that people add to our lives with words, but really cherish those people who make us feel good every time we're around them or every time we've spoken to them, people who make us feel safe and who don't make us feel like we have to constantly be in contact with them, like relationships can thrive regardless of whether you talk once a day, once a month, or once a year. I can see in the Two of Knives that you are definitely making some decisions during the month of October that will affect you for the future, and the Queen of Bottles shows me that you're being very responsible when it comes to the relationships that you're keeping and the ones that you're maybe kind of like bringing back just a little notch. And being responsible with this is something that comes with wisdom, something that comes with age and experience for you. The Five of Pills, last but not least, it does show me here that it's important for you to not in a way cause any friction in your career, to not fight for a spot that isn't meant to be. This is another area where wisdom can be gained. If you feel like in your job, in your career, or maybe in your studies, you always have to fight to make it to the next step, or you have to fight really hard just to stay employed or to make exams, and it's not even fun, it's not fulfilling, it's not doing anything for you, it just constantly feels like a battle and a competition, maybe it's not for you, and maybe after you have been able to get to a certain point, like get that diploma that you've been working on for a while, of course don't abandon something that you're close to reaching, or get that to that next stage in your promotion, or save up enough money so you can finally switch jobs or do your own thing. Actually take that leap of faith and don't feel as though like it's normal to always feel like you're competing. I never feel like I'm competing. I always feel like I just love what I'm doing here on YouTube and with my business, Bow Life, and I want you to feel the same way, group number four. I never want you to feel like you're in competition with other people, with the system, like you're comparing yourself, like you have to have a certain score. It's important for you to really enjoy what you do and what you spend most of your waking moments engaged in. So group four, this is the first part of your October prediction that I received for you, and I really hope it resonated and that you found it insightful. Make sure that you leave a little banana emoji down below in the comment section, as the banana did show up within your reading, and just as a little token to let others know that you made it to the end of the first part of your prediction. Furthermore, all of the timestamps to the zodiac signs can be found down below in the description box, as well as pinned to the comment section, so feel free to click your zodiac sign and be fast forwarded to the second and even more personal part of your October prediction. I'll see you over there. Hello, all my beautiful Aries babies, and welcome to your zodiac sign's October prediction. So I'm gonna get straight into it. Well, all you need to do is lean back, relax, and enjoy your highly personalized October horoscope. As an Aries baby, you are adventurous, courageous, and rather confident, especially compared to the other signs of the zodiac. So let's see what messages are present for you for the month of October. First up, we have the Six of Wands. The Six of Wands shows me that you're going to be really triumphant in October with anything that you feel passionate about. And as an Aries babies, you're definitely someone who shows when they're passionate about something, and you're definitely the type of person who puts 110% of their energy into a project if they are convinced of it. And because you're someone who can also be a bit of a daredevil, you take calculated risks that often actually turn out in your favor. To everybody's surprise, next in the Strength card, I can see here that for October, you definitely feel like you are as strong as ever, like you have reached some sort of new level of strength. I see that here in connectivity to the Six of Wands, because you have a lot of success and you have a lot of triumphant moments that are coming for you in October. You also feel as though, just in general, you're almost like a bit invincible, so to say, my Aries babies. This may result in you acting in a bit more of a careless way than you usually would, but there's a reason why you're receiving your October prediction right now and why you're here. So ensure that you're not in over your head just because you feel like you're kind of on top of the world. Next up, we have the Tower. So all my beautiful Aries in the Tower, I can also see here that there is a sense of destruction that is coming towards you during the month of October. And as you know, I do not prepare any piles. I want to be straightforward and honest with you. I would rather tell you the truth than comfort you with cards that I have pre-selected to be purely positive. So definitely know here in the Tower that we have something that you're dealing with that isn't so easy. I can see in the Five of Pentacles that it has to do with you walking away from a business deal that you thought would work out, walking away from someone who maybe promised that they would pay you back, promised that they would give you back what you put or invested into them or their idea, but you're just coming to the realization that they may never do that. So it seems as though in October, on one hand, you're very triumphant and strong when it comes to your own personal accomplishments and your own personal projects, but I definitely see that there is some sort of friendship or bond that is breaking apart. I see that here in the Tower, all because you feel as though you have invested more time and money and effort into the relationship than was given back into it. So you've missed the reciprocity, and that is why you felt as though the situation was no longer sustainable. And this is definitely something that I can understand, and that no one looks at you as the bad guy for, all my beautiful Aries. I can see here within the Ace of Cups that as quickly as someone left your life who maybe played you or who maybe gave you false hope about ever giving you the same effort back that you put into the relationship, again, it could be a friend or a family member who lent money from you or lent a lot of time from you and never actually intended to give it back. I see that as quickly as you're losing them or letting go of them, knowing that that connection is never going to be the same, you're also finding someone completely new. And I see that here in conjunction to the moon, that you instinctively know who a real friend is and who is just here in order to take a little to-go meal, to-go snack from you, and then kind of like leave you stuck with the bill. So I can definitely see in the Ace of Cups as well as the moon that you are making new connections and new friendships that feel right just from the start, and that you can tell are just completely different than the connections that you had that we spoke about here in the Five of Pentacles. The Page of Swords definitely also shows me that because you are learning so much about human behavior, who to trust and who not to trust, that October is definitely an intense month for you. It is a month with ups and downs, with your emotions being a little all over the place. And because as an Aries, you're definitely someone who is dynamic and quick-witted, this movement is something that is fun for you, but on the other hand can also make you feel a little bit extra impatient. So it's almost like the more that's going on around you, the more that your personal pace heightens as well, and the more it's kind of like you cannot calm down, the harder it is for you to truly relax, right? It's almost like if you've had a dog who is super into playing ball or is super high strung and you continue to feed into it, you won't tire the dog out. Quite the contrary, you'll just make them used to that type of behavior or that type of high strung nature, and they will just be able to withstand even longer periods of high strung energetic outbursts, which will in the end just result in some sort of burnout. So it's very important for you to take care of yourself and to ensure that you're not doing too much. The Two of Cups shows me here that you have people who truly care about you, all of my beautiful Aries, and people who want to spend that QT with you, that quality time. So definitely make use of that and take people up on their offers to just relax and chill. I know it may seem really counterintuitive during the month of October, given how much is going on for you, but just taking some time to calm down, to rest and recuperate is the healthiest thing that you can do for yourself during the next month. Next up, we have the Three of Cups. So all my beautiful Aries in the Three of Cups, I want you to know here that having fun celebrating some sort of birthday party or other celebration is a big part of October for you and is definitely going to leave a mark that you will remember for months and possibly even years to come. The Five of Diamonds here is basically the exact same card as the Five of Pentacles, just from my gentle heart tarot deck. So do know here in the Five of Diamonds that letting go of a friendship and a connection that you can tell is just not meant to have that healthy dynamic of that person giving just as much into the relationship as you have, it's something that's not easy for you, because once you like someone, you really do enjoy their company, and losing them is something that isn't easy for you and is definitely going to weigh on you during certain moments of privacy during the month of October. I can see here within the Sweet Corn that a great way for you to get over the fact that you put a lot of effort into giving someone the benefit of the doubt and they maybe did not perform the way you hoped that they would is to give yourself some time for not just self-care, but also like create a ritual that you do every day to make yourself feel good and to remind yourself of the fact that you doing good and you believing in the good of someone, that just shows how strong that you are and how much of a caring person that you can be. That is not a reflection that should be embarrassing to you at all, that someone was able to take advantage of your good nature. It should actually just tell you that, hey, some friendships and relationships will work out, and with other relationships, you just sooner or later have to realize that you were putting more into the friendship and relationship than the other person intended to put into it. And it's okay, because the fact that you didn't expect anything and you just did everything that you could from the goodness and the depth of your heart just says so much about what a wonderful person that you are. I can see here within the Fennel that your inner strength is triggered during the month of October. We already had the Strength card show up for you here in the tarot. And I do want you to understand here that strength is something that comes from within and is something that you just can't see on the outside. And you're realizing how strong that you've always been, all my beautiful Aries, and how much of a pillar that you are in your community, how much of a light that you are to other people who look up to you and want to be just as strong as you are no matter the situation. The potato shows me that October will be a very grounding month for you, where you remember that no matter how triumphant and victorious that you are in your own personal pursuits, that doesn't mean that everything is perfect. And it also reminds you that celebrities, people who are highly successful, entrepreneurs, artists, you name it, they all struggle with the same stuff. They are just as human as you and I are, and it doesn't matter how successful that you are, everyone struggles with their own personal business. The watermelon shows me here that fertility is high around you. The energy of fertility is definitely in a place where it can be used, all of my beautiful Aries, and where fertility is something you should be aware of, especially if you're not looking to delve into the fertile aspect of your body. Maybe you're just not ready, and that's completely fine. Then do know here that the watermelon and the fertility notion is something that you can look out for and just be extra careful with. The Shungite shows me here that detoxifying your life is a big part of October, and the detoxification is what we spoke about in the Tower, and the fact that some things aren't meant to last, and it's okay, because where there is a void, it will be filled fairly quickly as we have a new relationship entering your life in the Ace of Cups, a new connection, a new friendship that is mutually beneficial and respectful. The Two of Cups and the Three of Cups does show me that what will actually really override any type of disappointment that you may have experienced in the Five of Pentacles and Five of Diamonds is celebrating, having a good time, partying with people who you get along with magnificently and who truly appreciate you and put just as much effort as you do into maintaining a connection. So all of my beautiful Aries, this is the October prediction that I received for you. I truly hope that you enjoyed enjoyed it and that you found it insightful, leave a watermelon emoji down below in the comment section if you made it to the end of your zodiac sign's prediction. And of course, to represent, to let me and your fellow Aries brothers and sisters know that you were here. Thank you so much for spending this divine time with me, and I'll catch you during another one of my monthly predictions. Hello, all of my beautiful Taurus babies, and welcome to your October 2021 prediction. So let's move into it to figure out what is coming towards all of my beautiful Tauruses of this world, so you can enter October feeling prepared and feeling like you have everything under control. As a Taurus, you're patient, reliable, you're very warm-hearted as well as determined. Now let's see how that reflects within your reading. In these star, I can see here that there is a lot of hope for things to look better for the rest of the year for you, as well as for 2022. So all my beautiful Taurus babies, the star shows me here that October is a month that restores your confidence as well as your self-love, in a sense of understanding that you're capable of so much more than you actually give yourself credit for. The Page of Wands reverse does also show me here that you're finally going to find it in you to restart a project that prior to October may have been unsuccessful. So retake an exam that you failed, retry for a promotion, or just get back into starting your own business, even though at an earlier point you felt defeated or you felt as though maybe it's not meant for you. The star is a sign of you finding newfound hope and confidence to look into the things you've always wanted to do and move into them without any fear. I can see here in the Six of Pentacles that you are of a very generous spirit, a very giving spirit, all of my beautiful Taurus babies. You are very generous as a sign in general, lots of G's within these sentences, but do know here that especially in October, maybe you're invited to a party or you're invited to some sort of gathering where you're bringing a gift or where you're showing just how generous that you can be and how caring that you are. And you're doing so by spending time, energy, effort, and money on other people. And I can definitely see that charitable causes will work out beautifully for you, as they will channel more energy of abundance into your life the more you engage in that type of frequency during the month of October. So keep in mind, the energy that you put out is the energy that you'll receive. The law of attraction works every single time. Next, we have the King of Swords. The King of Swords does show me here that your words cut deep during the month of October, and anyone who crosses you is going to wish that they would not have, all my beautiful Taurus babies. Be very gentle and careful with your words, as I can see that you may cause some sort of rift with a close friend or family member if they catch you on a bad day or on a day where you feel exceptionally hangry. The Chariot reverse does show me that October is a month where you're not going to make too much progress when it comes to moving forward in ventures that are complacent at the very moment. And I would rather be honest with you, all my beautiful Taurus babies, than just create readings that are all positive and that are all about how you're gaining so much access, so much money, but that will very quickly grow old. So I do want you to know here within the Chariot that you're rather complacent in October, and you're working more on really honing your skills in the area that you're at right now. Okay, so really making your home beautiful, really ensuring that you're studying hard for upcoming tests, or that you're putting your all into your career for the next promotion. There's not going to be any type of like big bang that's happening for you. October is more about preparing. It's more about preparation for big things to come. And this may make a lot of sense for you if you're looking at doing something in November, December, January that you're still preparing for during the month of October. I can see here within the Queen of Wands that an important thing for you to do is to plan ahead, and that it's very important for you to also ensure that you're communicating with with everyone who is involved in projects that you're trying to get together, and that you give them the necessary timelines and that you give them heads up on what you expect. The Knight of Pentacles does show me here that, again, you're kind of like preparing for bigger financial success. The Knight of Pentacles shows me that on one hand, you're definitely being frugal during the month of October, but on the other hand, you're also preparing for your success in the future. So you're investing your time and money into things that will give you a return, and you're being very frugal in your day-to-day life and in spending money on things that are basically just pure expenses that couldn't possibly have any financial gains or returns in the future. I can see here in the big picture thinking that that is exactly what you're about, all my Taurus babies. You are reading, you're learning, you're informing yourself of this big picture thinking. You have inspired ideas. You're thinking about the future in a way of delayed gratification. You would way rather work hard now or spend a few years of your life in a way that others couldn't or wouldn't, in order to then enjoy your life in a way that others wish that they could. So do know here in the big picture thinking that you're basically just preparing for a life filled with material and earthly prosperity. And if you have to kind of minimize your spending and invest every penny that you have into business ventures, into stocks, into real estate, just things that you know will give you return, you're willing to do that because you're thinking for the big picture, and there's no reason why you can't spend a couple months or years of your life working hard in order to propel yourself to a place where you feel comfortable and where you feel like you've accomplished some of the big goals that you had for yourself in the earthly realms. Baby steps. So in baby steps, do know here that following your intuition, even before it makes sense, that is what October is all about for you. So you're not going to see any big lottery wins or returns yet, because you're just in the preparation phase, all my beautiful Taurus babies. You're all about following your intuition moving forward, and following your intuition in preparing for your life ahead, rather than knowing that, okay, this is 100% going to work. Like, nobody who starts their own business or nobody who invests in real estate really knows for sure or 100% whether it will work out in the long term or not. They just have to follow their gut feeling, and these are the type of money moves that I see you making. The portal does show me here that you're building your little portal, you're building your little time machine in order to open doors for yourself that people around you may have never had access to. So even in your family, you may be the very first one who is making these very smart and financially literate decisions that will put you into a completely different area code of society the more you stick to spending in a smart way, and the more you stick to being financially literate, smart, and ensuring that your investments will give you a great return. I can see here in the Chrysocolla that maybe in the past you were all about looking wealthy or looking like you have everything put together, but moving forward, you're all about actually being put together, actually having a bank account that looks healthy, actually investing it in things. Even if on the outside you look like you're just a very regular person, or even like you're not as wealthy as others, you would rather look average and know that you have all of your ducks in a row and everything is in alignment with what you're trying to achieve with your big picture thinking, than to just look wealthy but actually be broke and worried about where your next meal is going to come from. I can see here within the red jasper that you're taking action in October, which is amazing for you to see. You're so focused on your grind, so focused on your financial future, which is an important part of our life here on planet Earth. I mean, only the very few are able to not have to worry about finances because they either live off grid in a way that they don't need a lot of money and whatever they make is enough to sustain them. Some people, of course, do come from a wealthy background of generational wealth. So do know here in the Red Jasper that you are taking action in order to build stability for you and in order to not have to overthink finances in the future. And you're creating this portal to a future that you know is going to be so much more chill and relaxed for you than if you were just to say to yourself, YOLO, I only live once, let me spend all my time, energy, and money on impressing other people. That is not you, all my beautiful Taurus babies. You are so focused on your future, on your delayed gratification, and on big picture thinking, which is really mature and something you should be proud of. So keep your head down during the month of October. You're doing amazing, and future you is going to thank you. So all of my beautiful Taurus babies, this is the zodiac portion of your October prediction. I really hope you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Leave a money bag emoji down below in the comment section just to further manifest what you're drawing into your life. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Gemini babies, and welcome to your October 2021 prediction. So I'm gonna get straight into your zodiac signs portion of the reading. Okay, we have a card that popped right out of the pile. We've got the Death card, all of my beautiful Gemini babies, and I definitely don't want you to be afraid, and I definitely also hope that you appreciate my honesty and that I stick to whichever cards that each sign receives, no matter what. So in the Death card, we have a new beginning for you in October. Contrary to popular belief, the Death card is not actually a negative card. This is not actually a card to be afraid of. The Death card stands for a fresh beginning. It stands for you being able to turn a new page and overall leaving the old behind, right? It's like the death of the old, the death of what is no longer needed and what no longer resonates with you moving forward. So we have a lot of renewal for you during the month of October and a lot of fresh beginnings. The Eight of Cigarettes definitely also shows me that when it comes to the stuff you're passionate about, when it comes to the things that you love, all of my beautiful Geminis, you are all about that and you want to spend more time doing what makes you happy rather than spend time doing different tasks to satisfy others or to satisfy society's needs. I can see here within the Tower that these changes are going to be profound that are coming for you. So these are no small changes. These are lifestyle choices that will affect your October greatly. And I can definitely see here in connection to the Death card that this new beginning is something that may come as a little bit of a shocker or surprise for you. But in the grand scheme, I see in the Eight of Cigarettes, you understand that it's for the good of it all and that actually moving forward, you can accomplish so much more if you just allow for this new beginning to take place. Next up, we have the Two of Swords. So all my beautiful Geminis, the Two of Swords shows me here that decision-making is your forte during the month of October. Decision-making and leaving some things behind that you no longer need while taking other things with you. And that resonates beautifully with the Death and the Tower card, because in the Death and the Tower card, you're going to have to make tough decisions and decide exactly which aspects of your life or life how you've known it up until October you want to take with you, and which aspects of life how you've known life that you want to leave behind and that you feel that you could better grow without. Next we have the Lovers. So a fresh beginning in love. I can see here within the Lovers, we have some sort of sensual chemistry that is present for you. We have chemistry here with another person that is rooted in love, affection, and care for one another. So the Lovers is definitely a positive sign if you are looking to expand your love life or your romantic experiences and just overall attract a caring partner into the vicinity for yourself. The Knight of Wands does show show me here that the person you're attracting during the month of October is a fire sign. This is someone who's around your age, maybe slightly younger, all my beautiful Gemini babies, and they are ambitious, they're very energetic, they're very quick-witted and confident. That's what I see here in the Knight of Wands, as well as the Lovers. And this is a type of person that you feel you can go on different adventures with. This is the type of person that you feel is there even through difficult times, but of course, they prefer the more lighthearted times because the Knight of Wands does not like to talk about their feelings all that much. Next, we have the Nine of Cups. Nevertheless, you're happy, all my beautiful Geminis. Nevertheless, feel like your life is in a pleasant place and you feel like, hey, I could reside here, because these fresh beginnings, the big changes that we have in the Death and the Tower card, rather at the beginning of the month of October for you, are actually serving you in the long run, and you're noticing that. You're becoming very aware of that fact, and it's definitely something that you're grateful for in the long run especially. But now let's move further into your October prediction to just derive a few more details for you so you can better prepare yourself. We have the Magician. So the Magician definitely shows me here that there are so many different areas of your life that will be affected this October and that you're going to be working on. The Magician is kind of like a jack of all trades. The Magician affects your love life, your personal life, your career. And I can definitely see here when we connect that to the Tower, the Eight of Cigarettes, and the Death card, that your changes are going to affect every area of your life and nothing will be the same after October. In karmic relationships, I can tell here that soul growth is something that you've been needing for a long time, and because you've maybe been putting off the soul growth, you've maybe been putting off the soul expansion that you've been due for, that may have created conflict for you, my beautiful Geminis, and that's maybe also why now during the month of October, it feels like a big sense of relief and release to step into the person that you should have been already weeks and months ago. The big picture thinking does show me here that you're really ready for what's coming for you in October. Big picture thinking is all about Pleiades energy. You're like a visionary. You have tons of inspired ideas about how you can make the best of every situation and how you can use the changes that are present to your advantage and ensure that you're getting what you desire out of life. Falling into my arms shows me here that surrendering and holding the opposites, the extremes of life, are affecting you in a very profound way. So when I described the Knight of Wands, you may have felt like that is the direct opposite of a human being compared to who you are. You may have felt here in the Knight of Wands that this person is someone who is exciting, someone who is just simply not you, where there is polarity, where you're the complete opposite. And falling into my arms does show me here that surrendering to someone who is completely different than you, all my beautiful Geminis, is going to serve you immensely, because you don't need more you energy romantically. You don't need more of what you already possess. I can definitely see that life is so much more full for you if you allow unknowns as well as things that you're not used to into your life and into your space. I can see here within Jump In that there is a lot of this adventurous energy that surrounds this relationship, and that a fated message for you, a message from the universe, is to just say yes to the change. Say yes to what's coming. Don't be the person who always needs to kind of like think about it. If someone asks you to spontaneously do something for a change, just say yes. Don't overthink it. Don't check your schedule too intently. If you know that you have half a day to spare or however long it is, just say yes and see what happens. I can see here within lifting the veil that questioning everything is just in your nature as a Gemini. You're someone who is very intelligent. You're someone who is
very intellectual and eloquent, and you like to think things through before you do them. You like to think things through before you take any type of action, especially action that you may regret at a later point in time. So in lifting the veil, I can definitely see that just being more spontaneous is serving you in a way of lifting the veil of fear that spontaneity is going to hurt you, and lifting the veil of being afraid that spontaneity may result in something that you later on regret. I can see here within the lemon that October is definitely a cleansing month for you, a month where you're letting go of limiting beliefs around being spontaneous, where you're letting go of rigidity and things as you've known them up until the month of October. Last but not least, the grape shows me that October is an abundant month for you. It's a month of a lot of change, a lot is happening, and I hope you can appreciate my honesty, all my beautiful Gemini babies. Leave a grape emoji down below if you do, and if you've made it to the last card of your October prediction. So do know here in the grape that overall, this is going to be a month that you will look back on and think to yourself was an abundant month. It was a month where you definitely took a lot of lessons with you, where a lot of positive changes occurred, even though those changes may have seemed really big, daunting, and scary at first. In the end, they served you greatly. So all of my beautiful Gemini babies, this is your October prediction. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming monthly predictions. Hello, all my fellow Cancerians, and welcome to your zodiac sign's October prediction. So I'll move straight into it. All you need to do is lean back, relax, and enjoy this highly personalized approach to your October reading so we can figure out all of the little details about the upcoming month for you. So we have the Four of Cups as well as the Knight of Wands. So I can see here in the Four of Cups and the Knight of Wands that there is someone who talks a big game, who is kind of going to leave you feeling a bit disappointed and upset because they promised you the world, but they're not delivering. And as a Cancerian, I completely understand that this is something that would hurt you and that would make you feel upset, and that would also make you question the connection as a whole. So this is something that you're dealing with in October that you're kind of not sure what to do of. I can see here in the Temperance card, as a Cancerian, emotions can run high. You're a very loving, intuitive, as well as protective person, but you're also very protective about your own heart many times. And when someone wrongs you, it's not really something that you want to get over or that you can get over very easily. So it's essential for you to allow yourself to be true to who you are in this situation, because if someone kind of promised you the moon, the stars, and the sky, and they delivered absolutely nothing, just one little molecule of oxygen, then it is, of course, completely your right to feel disappointed and to think to yourself to go onto the other extreme of the spectrum and just not trust that person from here on out until they've proven that they are in fact trustworthy. I can see here in the Devil reversed that we have a very positive sign for you. The Devil reversed actually does show that rather than just blindly going back into the situation and trusting the person again and giving them the benefit of the doubt, you are making them work for your attention and affection. You're making them work for your love as well as your time, which is something that a lot of people fail to do. A lot of people give second chances immediately, but for you, this is not something that's happening so easily. The Eight of Cups does show me that you have bigger, better, other things to care for during the month of October than just this one person and their mood swings, let's just put it that way. As you know, sometimes they feel as though they want to promise you everything. Other times they kind of tell you, well, what did you expect? Your expectations were just way too high. That's what I mean with mood swings. You're not dealing with it. You're not here for it, all my beautiful Cancerians, and you're simply abandoning that situation altogether. The Eight of Wands shows me that your life is moving very rapidly into a different direction that you feel way more passionate about, that you can find a lot more freedom as well as happiness in, and you're following that path. So you're not hung up on anyone. You're not allowing yourself to become too consumed with what happened with the Knight of Wands person, with this person who is heavy on fire signs, who is maybe a little younger than you and a little bit immature. You're allowing them to be immature however long that they want to be immature, but you're not going to let it affect your life moving forward. As I can see in the Temperance card and the Eight of Wands, that you know you have other responsibilities that would benefit greatly from your attention and from you keeping your head in the game. I can see here in the Aeolite that it's all about your money mindset. It's all about what you're doing financially and optimizing that. And of course, if you are hung up on another person romantically or in a friendship, it can be really hard or almost impossible to focus on your finances or your career, which is why you're ripping your mind off of anything that doesn't serve you financially and in your career, and refocusing on your money mindset, shifting that completely into a place where forward movement and growth is possible. So if you have to leave someone behind in order to be in that space, then that just shows you that that relationship was blocking your financial and earthly abundance to begin with. The Tourmalinated Quartz does show me here that you're just getting out of your own way. You're not letting your feelings get in your way. As a Cancerian, you are known to be emotional, sometimes even moody or very touchy, clingy. The Tourmalinated Quartz does show me here that rather than being all of those traits that you are known to exert at times, you are completely moving into this independent state. You have one mood or another. Either you're kind of clingy, moody, and very sensitive, or you're just like, I don't care. I'm moving forward. I never want to speak to this person again. I never want to have to deal with the situation again. I have so much better stuff going on in my life that I'm not going to waste any of my time on this. And I can definitely see that you're in a I don't give a F mood during the month of October, and I'm here for it. I can see here within the Garnet that you're igniting your passions instead, and you're reminding yourself of who you are. I also did notice that you have a lot of very dark crystals that popped out of the pile for you. And these dark crystals are actually absorbent type of crystals. They absorb energies that are unwanted, that are unnecessary. So negative energies, energies that don't serve you, and they are very protective because they absorb these unwanted energies and you no longer have to deal with them. So the Garnet does definitely show me here that igniting your passion, igniting stuff that you really love, protects you with this cloak of confidence that you otherwise may have been missing. Loosening your grip is something that therefore is like a coping mechanism for you in October. Just letting go of who and what does not serve you in order to alleviate any areas of density that you may have had in your body and your existence, any addiction that you may have had to a person or a situation that is emotionally very triggering. So I can definitely see in loosening your grip that this is serving you in the sense of not being hung up on a situation and not becoming addicted to drama, because this is probably the hardest thing to admit. But some of us in certain situations can be addicted to drama, to the tea, to the gossip. And in order to notice that you have been like that in certain situations, you have to be mature and very honest with yourself. And being able to loosen your grip on that is actually something that very few people are ever able to do. So you should be proud of yourself. Falling into my arms does show me here that surrendering is something that will come as a result in October to you, because you're just in such a mature, such an open and honest place with yourself that surrendering to whatever you may receive is something that comes naturally and is a complete like other extreme of where you started out. At the beginning of October, you may have thought to yourself, I don't know if I should give this person another chance, this person who disappointed me, who maybe betrayed me or backstabbed me. And I can see here that the complete other extreme to you by the end of October is to just surrender to the fact that this relationship wasn't meant to be and that you have bigger, better things coming for you. Next, we have the Ace of Wands as well as the Wheel of Fortune. The Ace of Wands definitely shows me here that you have new, innovative, fun ideas about what you would like to do in life. The Wheel of Fortune shows me that you're kind of deciding in a very clear manner who is coming with you on this exciting ride and who is being left behind. The Ace of Wands does show me here that this is a completely new and fresh approach to your life, your career, and your romantic life as well. The King of Wands shows me that actually you are completely going to upgrade from this person who disappointed you, and the Knight of Wands, who is kind of like immature, who can't keep their word, okay, whose integrity is lacking, to the King of Wands, who is someone who is far more mature, respected, who has integrity, who has a moral compass, and who stands by their word, who keeps their promises, especially when they make a promise to you, because they care about your emotions. They care about what you go through, and they don't want to add any extra stressors to your life. The Hierophant shows me that what has made them so mature is everything that they've been through, and also just the fact that rather than feeling like they are the big teacher or the big boss, I mean, even if they are literally a teacher in some sense or the boss of a business and an establishment, they don't act that way. They don't put themselves on a pedestal, and they just give people advice whenever they can and wherever they can, and they try to help people out of the goodness of their heart. And this is someone who just works way better for you, all my beautiful Cancer babies. This is someone who you can vibe with, who you can resonate with, because emotional maturity is a must in order for you to feel safe and to further want to surrender, like we had within the Fall Into My Arms card. So all my beautiful Cancerians, this is the October prediction that I received for you. I hope you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Leave a little crab emoji down below in the comment section to represent and to let me and others know that you made it to the end. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming monthly predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Leo babies, and welcome to your October 2021 prediction. So I'm going to move straight into it. All you need to do is lean back, relax, and enjoy this highly personalized approach to a monthly prediction. First up, we have the Judgment card that popped right out of the pile. And when I say popped right out of the pile, this card definitely wants to speak to you. The Judgment card is all about seeing things crystal clear and no longer allowing yourself to see things through rose-colored lenses or rose-colored glasses, however you'd like to call it. As a Leo, you are definitely a very warm-hearted, caring person. You're super generous and giving. And one thing about the Judgment card is that you need to call it quits sometimes, all my beautiful Leo babies, okay? You cannot always be loving, giving, and generous to people who are not returning the favor appropriately. The Two of Knives, I can definitely see that decisions will have to be made about who you're keeping around and who has guts to go, my Leo babies, okay? Because the Judgment card does show me here that you may have been playing yourself a little bit when it comes to relationships in your life and feeling like you could rekindle them, or maybe people will change. Nobody's going to change in October. Okay, so protect yourself, protect your heart, protect your generosity, spend it on people who appreciate it. The Tower does show me here that there's some profound changes that are coming your way in October, and these changes mean that there will be a complete revamp of how you experience life and what type of friends and family that you keep around. The Fool shows me here that this fresh beginning is one that you have never experienced before, and this new beginning comes with a lot of great opportunity as well. So of course, every time that you get to start afresh, you get to design what your life looks like, and you get to decide exactly what is going on around you. Now, the Devil card does show me here that you are definitely looking at some people romantically with who you could start over as well during the month of October, but ensure that this isn't like an ex or someone who you've been with before, as I can see here connected to the Two of Knives, the Tower, and the Judgment card, that it's a big no-no for you. Anyone who you've already had a situationship or relationship with and with whom that didn't work out, stay far away from them. All that I can see there is heartbreak. All that I can see here with the Devil is maybe like a fun encounter and maybe just being romantic for a little bit, sharing one another's physical bodies, but the love not really being rooted where it needs to be. I can see here within called that you have so much more to offer than you realize, and that during the month of October, it's important for you to step up to the plate and to remind yourself of that as well. Your soul gifts and training is one thing that you're called to engage in, and also to disengage from anyone who isn't honoring how much that you can offer to this world and how much you can offer to a relationship, both romantic or platonic. I can see here in Forge, Don't Follow, that you are paving a new path and you're being the leader that you wish you had. So especially growing up, you may have not had any role models that came from the same background you came from, that maybe looked the way that you looked, all my beautiful Leo babies, but I see that October is a month where you're coming to the epiphany and realization that actually you are the one paving the way. Actually, you are the one who is being that poster child, who is becoming that person that others can look up to. And do know here in Forge, Don't Follow, that you are meant to stand out, not to fit in, and that sometimes when you haven't had any role models, you have to become the role model yourself. I can see here in the Bay that through wisdom, through spending a lot of time reflecting and asking yourself why life or this world has been the way it's been to you, you have grown immensely in wisdom as well as in your character, and this is furthermore a reason why you are meant to be the one paving the new path and clearing the way for others. I can see here within the Lime that this is actually something that you're really lucky to be able to do, because you will always be the one who paved the way. There is no one who can replace you, no one who can take that from you, even if new people come along who reach even bigger, greater heights, you know, decades down the line. I do want you to know, all my Leo babies, that you are the one who will always be looked at as the OG and who will always be the one who made that first most daunting step, and no one will be able to compare to that or compare to you. The Peppermint shows me great success coming for you in October, and with great success, of course, also comes a lot of fun, a lot of abundance, and happiness. But success is definitely a double-edged sword at times, because when you have a lot of success, you can sometimes feel a little overwhelmed or even lonely because you feel so overwhelmed. So it's essential for you as well to put aside things that don't need to be dealt with so you can actually enjoy your success. So success isn't just something that happens to be happening. Success is actually something that you're wholeheartedly enjoying. I can see here within the Six of Swords reversed that you can move into a space where you feel like you can actually have fun, where you feel like your success is something that can be shared and where you don't have to hide it. So be very conscious of who you're sharing your successes with. I can see in the Justice card reversed that it's all about finding the right people who want to celebrate you and who do not feel jealous, because there are often people who want to know about your successes, but they turn salty or jealous really quickly. That's not the type of energy that you want around you. Make sure that you're surrounding yourself with people who like to talk about your success and who are happy for your success, rather than looking at it and wishing that they had a little piece of your pie. So all of my beautiful Leo babies, this is the October prediction that I received for you. I really hope you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Leave a little lion emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you were here and that you made it to the end of your zodiac signs portion of this reading. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Virgo babies, and welcome to your zodiac sign's October prediction. So I'm gonna get straight into it. All you need to do is lean back, relax, and enjoy part two of this highly personalized approach to your October horoscope. Now, who doesn't like a personalized horoscope every month? I mean, I know I love that. So make sure that you're subscribed to my channel to never miss your horoscope again. I've been posting all zodiac signs monthly horoscope for years now, so make sure you don't miss out. We have the Tarragon first, then the Sorrel, as well as the Cucumber. So I can see here within the Tarragon that October for all my beautiful Virgos is about regeneration. It's about getting yourself out of your shell. As a Virgo, you can be very modest, humble, and sometimes even a little bit shy. So do know here within the Tarragon that you're regenerating your confidence, and the Sorrel shows me here that you're receiving affection from another person that reminds you of who you are, reminds you of the fact that you are worthy and deserving of attention and affection and respect. The Cucumber also shows me here that October is going to be a rather emotional month for you, and a month that brings out the side of you that is deeply rooted in emotional type of energy and emotional connection. Because as a Virgo, you can sometimes be a little bit detached when you're being overly critical, when you're worrying, when you're being a little bit of a perfectionist. You can feel like emotions don't really play a role. All you want to do is to complete a task or a project perfectly. All you want to do is perform. But I can definitely see that October is a month of reconnecting to your more emotional side, even if it feels irrational, or even if it feels like it is just a very intuitive thing that you're not used to. In the Fennel, I can see that this actually proves a lot of strength from all my beautiful Virgo babies, because instead of just sticking to what you're used to, instead of sticking to what you know, you're actually okay with the fact that you're exploring more of your emotional side. You're okay with the fact that you are exploring a side of yourself that has remained in the dark or in the unknown for a while now, for quite a few weeks and months, and you find it to be really refreshing, and you find that it actually aids in your regeneration. We also have a lot of green here within your reading. This deck is filled with lots of different fruit, vegetable, as well as herbs, but for you, everything is green, everything is growing, everything is luscious. So rather than moving into like autumn or winter, it seems as though on a spiritual level, you're more within spring, you're more within a growth phase. I can see within the King of Cigarettes that there is a fire sign who you're pulling into your life who has some sort of effect on you emotionally during the month of October. And this fire sign is maybe someone who you know, but it also could be a new person. I can see here within the Hermit that they're bringing you out of hermit mode. They're bringing you out of feeling like you don't want to leave your house or your room. They're actually getting you to go out and do some fun stuff. Fire signs are known to be very adventurous and energetic, so it's no surprise here in the King of Cigarettes that this person is motivating you to get out of your comfort zone. The Two of Cigarettes definitely shows me here that you always have a foot on the gas and a foot on the brakes. The Two of Cigarettes shows me that you're definitely torn about hanging out with the King of Cigarettes because it seems too easy and too fun to be true, because as a Virgo, sometimes you tend to be such a perfectionist and so focused on a certain outcome that anything else just seems unnecessary, irrational, or like you don't want to deal with it. But that's where we have the King of Bottles as well as the Cucumber show up for you. A lot of that water sign energy, a lot of the energy within you that is being embraced that you're not used to, that is rooted in emotion, that is rooted in intuition rather than logic and rationality. So October is going to be really interesting for all my beautiful Virgo babies and is going to bring out a side of you that we've been missing. The Five of Wands as well as the Five of Swords. All my beautiful Virgos, you're definitely going to feel like you're a little bit in competition at your workplace or maybe even where you're studying. And with competition, I mean competition for grades, upgrades, promotions. The Five of Wands definitely shows me that there's some sort of brawl that's going on that you're maybe actually even witnessing from a bit of a distance, as I can see here in the Five of Swords, that you are thinking very long and hard whether you actually want to physically engage in this, okay? You are actually debating whether it's best for you to just lay low, listen to what's going on, but not actually be a part of it, as the Five of Wands shows me that some people are really getting into it, and you feel like maybe it's safest for you to just keep a safety distance and just watch, just see what's going on, rather than actively be a part of the drama. The Death card does show me here that October is going to come with some big profound changes, and this makes a lot of sense. As I was saying, there's some sort of squabble, there's some sort of competition over being the best, the greatest, the latest, and you just simply watching is going to show you this very monumental moment of death where everything changes, where someone in the end gets the promotion, someone in the end gets ahead of the game, and that completely changes the dynamic in the environment, in the work environment, in the study environment, whatever environment it is that the squabble is happening in. It could also be within your family, that all of a sudden that just completely changes how the group dynamic functions and how you all deal with one another. The Queen of Swords shows me here that an air sign is going to be in charge, and this air sign is someone who is very direct, very open, and they definitely do also try to ensure that they don't hurt other people's feelings. So this person who ends up emerging from the ashes, rising like a phoenix from the ashes, if you will. And this is like, you are observing all of this, all my beautiful Virgos. This is something you're just like watching, but I can't really see you wanting to get your hands dirty or wanting to be involved in this. But you see that the Queen of Swords emerges from this situation as the winner, as the person who ended up winning this physical fight, this physical kind of altercation. And with physical fight, I don't mean like literally beating one another up, but for example, at work, it may have been a physical race to, you know, who gets as much done as they possibly can, who overworks themselves to the bone to get the promotion. And that is where I can see that the Queen of Swords put in a lot of physical labor in order to then be in a space where they no longer have to do that, and they can just only put in mental work, mental labor, and they are kind of like a bit of a commander, and you're learning from what they've done. You're learning from the situation and simply observing so that you can implement the tactics that resonated with you in the future, and you can leave the things that you didn't like behind. So all my beautiful Virgos, you're doing a lot of learning when it comes to your career. You're doing a lot of just figuring out what you would do in a certain situation without actually getting involved in any messy type of altercation. In The King of Cigarettes as well as The Hermit, your personal life is full. Your personal life is filled to the brim with action, so you don't need to add that for yourself professionally. You don't need any more excitement, as I can see that there is tons going on for you already. So it's actually like a welcome change to not be in the spotlight when it comes to your finances or your career, when it comes to what it is that you do on a day-to-day as a job. It's actually really refreshing for you to be able to also kind of just sit back, sit in the shadows, and watch and observe. So all of my beautiful Virgo babies, this is the October prediction that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Leave a little flame emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you made it to the end of your reading. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Libras of the world, and welcome to your October 2021 prediction. I'm so excited to figure out what is coming towards your zodiac sign specifically, so let's move straight into it to figure that out, shall we? First up, we have the Aventurine. So all my beautiful Libras, I can see that in October, you're creating your own luck, you're creating your own prosperity, you're taking matters into your own hands. You're no longer just allowing for other people to decide whether you get the promotion, how much you earn, when you can take a vacation, when you can have some time off to take care of yourself. You're taking these matters into your own hands, and you're not embarrassed about it. You're not mad about it. You feel empowered. I can see here within the agate that in the past you may have felt really off balance. You may have felt like there is just no balance in your life, no work-life balance, no balance when it comes to having time to just do the things that you love. But I can see here in connection to the Aventurine that you are single-handedly changing that. The Golden Healer Quartz shows me that you're opening the door to new possibilities because of doing this. People can see that you're not going to be bossed around anymore. People can see here that while you can be so diplomatic and charming, you also have a certain edge to you that comes out whenever you have to protect yourself and whenever you realize that, hey, people are taking advantage of the fact that you are such a hard worker. I can see here within the Selenite that you're clearing out any clutter that you may have had that got in your way. So maybe you had even promises that you've made to other people that you have not fulfilled yet. So you're fulfilling them in October so that you know that all of your debts have been cleared and you can start everything on a fresh note and on your own terms. That's what October is about for you, all my beautiful Libras. It's about doing things on your own terms. I can see within the Rodonite that anyone who you feel has bossed you around wrongfully or has used your very diplomatic nature to their advantage, you're kind of like forgiving of that because now you are the person who is in control. Now you are the person who understands how this game works. And of course, if you move up in the ranks in your career or you become the CEO of your own company, you're going to use that knowledge to your advantage, not to strip people of their free time or to make them feel as though they don't have any other area in their life to which they can devote as much time and energy. But at the same time, you're definitely going to use certain tactics in order to ensure that your business is feasible and that things stay afloat. So the Rodonite shows me that you're finding a way to forgive people who took advantage of others and you want to do things better moving forward. In Lifting the Veil, I can see that you're questioning everything. As a Libra, you are an air sign who is kind of not just charming, but also really easygoing. So for you to be questioning everything, for you to be wanting to know every little detail is definitely something that a lot of people may not be used to, or a lot of people may find a little bit like weird, like they're taken aback. Why does this Libra baby all of a sudden want to know all the details? Why aren't they just okay with the answers that we are giving them? So you're getting to the bottom of certain secrets. You're lifting the veil. In your life is a canvas. I can see some manifestation taking place, some creative accountability, you spending time creating a life, manifesting things into your life that you desire, and also prepping for manifestation. So think creating a goal board, a vision board that can help you manifest. Think making time for creative endeavors that allow you to just be in your flow state and connect with what you've always wanted to draw into your life. And I'm sorry, I see an apology coming your way, all my beautiful Libras. I see righting past wrongs, as well as uprooting and moving on. We did briefly speak about it in the Rodenite and you finding a way to forgive, which is why I can see here that this defenselessness is coming from another person. This apology is being extended from another person because the Rodenite does imply that you are finding a way to forgive, that you are giving yourself the gift of forgiveness and moving on and no longer caring grudges with you or holding grudges. In the empathic starseed, I can see here this energy, sovereignty, and no longer absorbing what's not yours, as the empathic starseed is turning empathy to themselves. And if you are that empathic starseed in October, all my beautiful Libra babies, having empathy for yourself is also knowing when enough is enough, drawing a line in the sand and not absorbing any energy or any type of influence that isn't meant for you and doesn't serve you, but rather focusing on ensuring that you forgive people who have wronged you and that you remind yourself that your life is a canvas and that does not need to continue to dictate how you lead your life. In the geranium, we have lots of healing energy. The geranium does show me here that healing is something that comes to you naturally when you're in this place of growth, when you're in this place of forgiveness. So do know here that October will end up being a month that you can move forward from feeling refreshed, and you can move forward from feeling like any type of debt that you were owed was repaid and vice versa. Any type of bills that were due for you to pay, you have completely cleared, and you can move forward with your life on a very lighthearted, fresh, clean slate. So all of my beautiful Libra babies, this is the October prediction that I received for you. I also wish you a happy birthday if you are celebrating your birthday during the month of October. Do know that I wish you nothing but love, success, and happiness. Thank you for being here. Don't forget to leave a little fish emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you made it to the end, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Scorpio babies, and welcome to your zodiac sign's October prediction. So let's get straight into it so we can figure out exactly what's coming towards all my beautiful Scorpios in the world during the month of October. First up, we have the Eight of Cigarettes. So all of my beautiful Scorpio babies, you are definitely rolling your eyes a little bit at the world during the month of October, and for some reason you feel as though you're over a situation. Let's find out what that situation is. In the Seven of Bottles, I can see here that when it comes to love and when it comes to fake lovers, just fake friends in general, you're over it. As a Scorpio baby, you're definitely someone who's very intuitive and emotional. You're a passionate human being, and you're someone who's super magnetic. So for you, love is something that you take seriously. I mean, as a fellow water sign, I truly understand how you feel when you're rolling your eyes at people who play games with other human beings' feelings. So I can definitely see here that in October, you may be a shoulder to cry on for someone who's going through a tough time in love. The Two of Pills does show me here that that is taking away precious time from your career and precious time where you could just be chilling. The Two of Pills definitely shows me that you're in a bit of limbo because on one hand, you want to spend a bit of more time for yourself and your own mental health and well-being. And on the other hand, where you're in this limbo position is where you want to be a good friend. You want to be a good person. You want to be someone who is dependable and a shoulder to cry on or to lean on for that friend or family member who is going through a tough time in love. I can see here in the Fool that to you, it doesn't really make sense what people go through in love very often, because you just find that if they were to listen to their intuition more, then they wouldn't be in difficult situations and you wouldn't always have to pick up everyone's pieces. So in the Fool, I can definitely see here that someone's relationship in October is coming to an end. It's not yours, all my beautiful Scorpio babies, don't worry, but it's definitely going to impact you because you're going to spend a good amount of time helping that person through the breakup, helping that person get through this difficult month. The Page of Pills does show me here that when it comes to your career and what you're going through professionally, again, you need to be cautious that you don't take any setbacks just to be there for other people, okay? It is very important for you, of course, to be there for others, but do not sacrifice your career because of someone else's heartache or heartbreak. Plan around what is important to you in your life and in your career, especially when you're going through once in a lifetime changes or once in a lifetime opportunities. You will wish that you would have put yourself first if you allow for someone else's heartache to get between you and your success in October. So it's really not the month for you to divert too much of your energy on other people's issues. The Knight of Pills does show me here that taking responsibility for your career and your career's growth and moving forward is the first step towards ensuring that you are not putting yourself in a situation that is compromising your safety in your professional life and that is not compromising what you're able to accomplish in October, because you're kind of spread really thin between your personal life and your work life. The Ace of Knives shows me here that it's very important for you to cut off any hand that is taking up way too much time, space, and energy, as we have here within the Ace of Knives. So don't be afraid to say no to people. Don't be afraid to tell others when you just have other things going on and you simply just do not have time for them any second that they wish or every time that they're going through something, because there are definitely friends and family that will take advantage of your kind heart and take advantage of the fact that you're always there and that you're super caring and emotional, and they may just call you to their rescue all the time. So it's important for you to set boundaries as well, all my beautiful Scorpio babies. In the Courageous Peony, I can see here that October is going to be very multifaceted. So moving on from what could be a little bit of love drama, I can see here in the Courageous Peony that letting yourself be seen and letting your multifaceted, unique nature be seen is a part of October. So unveiling parts of yourself, if you are really into dance, music, singing, art, just different ways of expressing yourself. It could even be poetry. I do want you to know here in the Courageous Peony that during the month of October, just displaying your art in some way, shape, or form is a very healthy way for you to put yourself out there and to come out of hiding. In lifting the veil, that is quite literally what you're doing. You're lifting the veil of secrecy about the things that you are passionate about and that you're good at. And in another way, you are also answering people's questions, because a lot of people have questions about you as a Scorpio. You're someone who is a little bit secretive, a little bit mysterious, and you're a very magnetic person, but at the same time, it's hard for people to really feel like they know you. A lot of people may think that they know you on the surface, but to truly know the depths of you, that takes time and that takes patience. Where I can see in Lifting the Veil, as well as The Courageous Peony, that during the month of October, people will feel like they're finally getting to know the real you and they're finally getting to see the real you. So keep that up, because uncovering more parts of you is actually a really beautiful way to get closer to loved ones. I can see within the Golden Children next that your inner child is coming out and you're able to display the rare gifts that were given to you. So all I want you to know here in the Golden Children is to simply allow that inner child to come out. If as a kid you had a very challenging upbringing or a tough time feeling like you fit in or feeling like you could truly be yourself, know here that in October there will be various opportunities for you to undo that trauma or to simply work on that trauma and to no longer feel like the outsider or like the one who is misunderstood and who is just always on the sidelines trying to figure out what to do next and how to fit in. I can definitely see that things are kind of changing. They're actually going through a complete 180, and all of a sudden you are more of the cool kid than you've ever been before. Let's move further into your reading. We have the Magician. Now, the Magician is a card that speaks of a fresh, new, funky beginning personality wise. Okay, so you are definitely experiencing an increase in courage as well as self-confidence. In correspondence to the Golden Children, I can definitely see that this comes from a place of understanding just how rare some of the gifts that you're born with truly are, and that treating them with a lot of tenderness can just bring them out even more. Okay, we have a few cards that popped out of the pile that clearly want to speak and be a part of your reading. So first up, let's talk about the Four of Swords. So all of my beautiful Scorpio babies, in the Four of Swords, I can see here that not that much is going to change about how you see the world, but a lot is going to change about how the world sees you. And I can see here in the Knight of Wands that people are going to be impressed by how strongly you're coming off, like how ambitious you're coming off as, and how driven that you are, and how unafraid that you're becoming as a person as well. In the Lovers, I can see that that is really hyping up your value in the love market, your value out there as a spouse, as a partner, and I can see that that is increasing how attractive that you are to other people, and basically just, you know, on a scale from unattractive to very attractive, you are definitely tipping the scale at very attractive in October because of this energy that surrounds you. Energy doesn't lie, and it's definitely something that a lot of people are very drawn towards. Lastly, in the Five of Wands, I can see here that some people may actually even be fighting for your attention and fighting for your affection, because you're making this like debut of yourself in October, so to say, where you're unveiling just how direct that you can be, how strong you can be, and simply how unafraid that you are to embrace your multifaceted, unique nature. This is definitely something that draws a lot of attention to you and that makes a lot of people wish that they could see more of you in every sense of the way. So all of my beautiful Scorpio babies, this is your zodiac signs October prediction portion. I really hope that you enjoyed this two-part approach to a October horoscope and prediction. Let me know down below, also by leaving a Scorpio emoji in the comment section. That way you can let me and your Scorpio brothers and sisters know that you made it all the way to the end of your readings. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me. Know that I'm sending you so much love, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all of my beautiful Sagittarius babies, and welcome to your zodiac sign's October prediction. I'm so excited to figure out what is coming towards your sign during the month of October, so let's get straight into it, shall we? I'll be starting off with my tattoo tarot deck so we can unveil what's coming towards all my beautiful Sagittariuses of this world. So first up, we have the Three of Swords. In the Three of Swords, I can definitely see here that decisiveness is something that you will find is important during the month of October, because decision-making can decide over success or failure for you. I do see here within the Hierophant, because you're such a naturally optimistic sign, you're definitely someone who does not have that much fear when it comes to decision making compared to other signs of the zodiac. And this is actually a month that suits you really well, that is going to work out beautifully for you, because you are very straightforward and sometimes even blindly optimistic, which is actually helping you in October. I can see here within the Hermit that usually retracting, retreating, rethinking things, that is something that a lot of other signs would do naturally, but for you, you truly have to like give yourself a little bit of extra effort to retreat. Stepping away from taking action and getting things done, that's not easy for you, but it's definitely important in order to combat decision fatigue being something that arises in October. The Ace of Cups does also show me here that some sort of new connection, new friendship, or new lover is coming towards you in October. And this new connection is also going to show you how important it is to ensure that you give yourself time to recuperate, time to recharge, and that you can also do that with other people. You don't always have to recharge alone. You can spend time with others just relaxing and chilling and not even talking, just vibing in one another's aura. I can see here within the Strength card, all my beautiful Sagittarius babies, that you are on a roll when it comes to your courage and when it comes to not needing to aggressively display your strength, just knowing that you have inner strength, and that already being a statement in itself. So when you enter a room, you don't have to say who you are or what position you're working or what your job is in a given situation. Your energy just introduces you to other people automatically, and it introduces you in a very straightforward, strong, and mature type of way. In the Seven of Swords, I can see that because some people are feeling especially intimidated by you during the month of October, they may actually try to betray you, or they may try to go behind your back to make decisions because they are too afraid to ask you and they're too afraid to be upfront and direct about what's going on and about what their upcoming plans are. So this is especially important for you to know, and I hope you can appreciate my honesty. And the fact that I don't prepare any cards before my readings, I just allow for the messages to flow right through. I hope you can appreciate knowing that and understanding that, especially if you are a boss or you are someone who is in a position of power at your job or even in your studies, if you're leading a project, it's essential for you to know that in October, some people may feel so intimidated by you that they go behind your back and just start doing things that they really shouldn't be. So that can allow you to keep a closer eye on the situation. I can see here within the Black Kyanite that setting strong boundaries is something you should do right from the start of October, setting strong boundaries with friends, family members, co-workers, just ensuring that everybody knows what their role is and everybody knows not to stray from their job, not to stray from what it is that they are meant to do in order to fulfill a project. I can see in the Chrysoprase that because you are in such a like strong place when it comes to work, as well as your presentation of yourself, it can be a little bit hard for you to receive care, love, and nurturing energy from others, because you're just kind of used to being strong. You're used to being more of the tough one. So it might feel a bit weird, but try to allow yourself to receive and try to keep things really lighthearted and fun whenever possible, because there is already a lot of serious energy present for October for you. And the Aquamarine, going with the flow, is something that I see as important that's coming for you, all my beautiful Sagittarius babies, and not interrupting the flow. flow. So if the flow is pushing you towards just taking a nap, taking some time away from work, go with that flow. But if you're in a flow state and you kind of feel like working a couple extra hours or working on something over the weekend, a big project, then go with that flow as well, okay? Don't discriminate the flow. Go with whatever it's trying to tell you. I can see here in the lapis lazuli that we're back to the topic of decision making and how important it is for you to just make decisions and stick to them. But of course, also don't make them irresponsibly. As a Sagittarius, you can sometimes be so good at decision making that you even just go and blindly make decisions without thinking it through very much, what the consequences may be. And that could end up actually really coming to bite you in the butt. So try to be careful and think through a couple more scenarios before making any decisions in October, just to make sure you have every scenario and basis covered. The Four of Crystals shows me security. It shows me that you are making mature decisions for yourself in October, so you don't really need all that much help or all that much extra insight, as you're already handling yourself in situations really well. The Two of Diamonds, it does also show me here that work-life balance is something that you're handling amazingly during the month of October, and that you're drawing some very clear, distinctive lines in the sand about when you're working and when your free time is. And that again shows like strength, because you don't feel so intimidated to work all the time just to keep a job or just to make a good impression, that you kind of just like undermine taking care of yourself mentally as well as physically. You know that in order for you to perform and in order for you to live your best life, you need to take on a very holistic approach of taking care of yourself, and this is something that you do regardless of what the work culture may be in the establishment where you work or wherever it is that you're studying, wherever it is that your professional life is playing out. You are putting yourself first in many situations, and that makes other people look up to you and respect you, because it shows that you're fearless of the consequences. You're not afraid of being fired or being seen as lazy, because you know that you're not lazy and you're not insecure about that. So of course you're going to make time for yourself, time to snooze, time to recuperate when you know that it's necessary and healthy for you. So all of my beautiful Sagittarius babies, we are at the end of your zodiac sign's October prediction. I truly hope that you enjoyed this super personalized approach to a reading. Let me know down below in the comment section. Also leave a little water drop emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Capricorn babies, and welcome to your October 2021 prediction. So I'm going to move straight into it. What you need to do is lean back, relax, and enjoy this portion of your October horoscope. I hope that you like this two-part, highly personalized approach and that you find value in it. First up, we have the selenite for you. So all of my beautiful Capricorn babies, in the selenite, I can see that October is a great month for you to clear out clutter and anything that you no longer need. So stuff in your home, stuff in your office, stuff digitally, okay? Digital clutter is a real thing. It actually makes me just as nervous as real physical clutter. So make sure that you're clearing out digital clutter as well, because that is often a part of decluttering that is just forgotten. Next up, we have the turquoise for you. So in the turquoise, all of my beautiful Capricorns, I can see that prioritizing your health is important, especially your mental health, and especially what wonders clearing out clutter can do for your mental well-being. Because whenever you clear out clutter, it's like you're creating a completely new, fresh space for yourself to mentally reside in and for you to be able to enter your flow state to focus on other things than all of the messiness that's going on around you or in or around your home. So do know here that decluttering definitely has some positive effects on your mental health as well. Next, we have the aragonite. So in the aragonite, I can see here that releasing emotional baggage is what you will feel happening the more you declutter. It's going to be like a heavy weight or a stone is lifted from your chest, is just lifted from your shoulders, and like you can finally walk upright and straight again, like you no longer need to hide or kind of like duck your head, pull in your head whenever you enter an area of your home that is cluttered. The aragonite shows me here that releasing that baggage is going to be so freeing and so liberating. In the angel aura quartz, I can see that it will overall lighten up your mood so much. It will lighten up your mental and emotional well-being to an extent that you maybe have never experienced before. And you will find that you don't even know how you lived before decluttering. Like, you don't even know how it was possible for you to be happy or to live a content existence on this planet while living with so much clutter. So for you, cleaning up is definitely going to be super life-changing, and it's going to be something that you will not regret. Quite the contrary, you will wish that you'd have done it earlier. Next, we have the King of Cups. So in the King of Cups, I can see a water sign. I can see someone who's older than you, someone mature, someone who you maybe also do find a little bit attractive, all my beautiful Capricorns, okay? You're someone who is very disciplined, you're patient, you're careful, but when you're in love, you fall deeply and madly in love. You fall so hard. And in the King of Cups, I can see someone represented who has a lot of water sign energy, and who definitely excites you a lot more than other people usually do. The Three of Coins shows me here that you're going to want to spend a lot of time with this person, and this person is going to animate you to spend your coin a little more. But of course, by spending more time with this person, you're also spending more money, not necessarily because you're spending money on them, but because instead of working or saving money, being at home or with people who you know, you're going out a little bit more, or you're spending a little bit more on ensuring that you look and feel good for your meetups with the King of Cups. Next, in the Knight of Cups, I can see that this person is actually has like two sides, two big facets to them. On one hand, they are super mature, they know what they're doing, and they have that kind of authoritative energy. And on the other hand, in the Knight of Cups, they're really fun, they're really bubbly, they have very young and fresh energy. It just really depends what they're doing. At work, they are kind of more the person that is like feared and respected in the best way, okay? There are bosses that are feared and respected that people still love, but in their free time, they are really happy to be able to let their guard down a little bit more and to be able to just be themselves and not have to watch out for what words that they use and so on and so forth. In the Devil, I can see here that this person is definitely tempting you to get physical sooner than you usually would, all my beautiful Capricorns. I can see in the Devil that they are definitely also kind of like enticing you to do something that you know you shouldn't do, maybe opening up too quickly, or like I said, entering a committed relationship very quickly without thinking it through or without getting to know the other person well enough. And the Devil definitely is also a sign to not only watch out for commitments that are being taken on too lightly and too soon, but also for you acting out of character, all because of infatuation. Next, we have the Cauliflower. So in the Cauliflower, all of my beautiful Capricorns, I can see that October is a very transitional month for you in 2021. So it's like you're transitioning to the next phase, to the next kind of space and period of time within your life. And that's maybe also why you're not quite 100% yourself, as I can see that here within the Devil. But the Peppermint does show me that in order to be successful, in order to get to that next spot of success and superiority in your life, you have to just go through this awkward phase. And this phase is definitely going to teach you a lot about yourself and a lot about who you are when you're tempted in a sensual way, when you're tempted romantically, and how you can learn from that as well. In the Pansy, I can see that attraction is a big topic in October for you. The other months of the year may have been way more stale than October, but in October, it's like you're all hot and bothered. There are things going on romantically that you feel very excited about, and it's hard for you to look away. It's hard for you to not fall prey to someone who, yes, is genuinely interested in you, but also needs a little bit more time to solidify their opinion about being committed to you and only you. So look at things from a perspective of wholeness, from a perspective of trying to create a wholesome relationship. In order to create a wholesome relationship that is mutually respectful and beneficial, you, of course, need the person to get to know you. If you already put yourself on a silver platter for them and you already present yourself in every way, shape, and form to another person too early on, they may lose interest or they may feel as though you do this with absolutely everyone, even if they are the exception and it's the first time you're being so open and straightforward with someone. They are most likely still going to be suspicious as to whether this is your usual way, and that will make the connection feel less special. So give other people the full Capricorn you in small doses and allow for people to earn getting to know you, because you are truly a highly desirable, beautiful living being that deserves the time, energy, and effort of others to get to know them, and you don't need to put yourself up on a silver platter just to get other people's attention. So all of my beautiful Capricorn babies, this is your October prediction. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Make sure that you leave a little dove emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you made it all the way to the end. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Aquariuses of the world, and welcome to your zodiac sign's October prediction. So I'm gonna get straight into it. All you need to do is lean back, relax, and enjoy this second part of your October horoscope, making this video highly personalized and accurate for you. So first up, we have the Lovers. All of my beautiful Aquarius babies in the Lovers, I can definitely see here that when it comes to romantic love, you are on an all-time high during the month of October. The Lovers definitely shows here that passion, romance, overall getting yourself all hot and bothered is coming very naturally to your sign during the month of October. I can see here within the Seven of Cups that it is completely your choice who you would like to be in a relationship or who you would like to get physical with, who you would like to engage in risque behavior with, and you're definitely taking full advantage of all of the romantic opportunity that's here for you in October. And this is definitely something that isn't all that Aquarius-like. You are very friendly, honest, and loyal, but romance is not always your strong suit. However, during the month of October, you are a hopeless romantic, and anyone who gets to be around you is going to benefit from this amazing awakening of love, emotion, and romance deep within you. In the Five of Coins, I can see that when it comes to your career, you've definitely got your head in the clouds and your career is kind of like suffering a little bit because of that. Okay, you're not paying as good of attention as you usually do. It's not going to have like detrimental effects on your career, but it is not your strongest career month of the year, all my beautiful Aquarius babies, but that's okay. And I also hope that you appreciate my honesty within my readings and that I don't just tell you what you want to hear or manipulate the readings to look better than they are. Yes, October is maybe not your best month when it comes to your career, but it's definitely the hottest month for you during 2021 when it comes to your love life. In the Knight of Coins, I can see that when it comes to your career, you definitely still have some learning to do, some honing of skills, and ensuring that you don't miss a beat in the upcoming months. So October October is going to teach you how to create more balance between your love life as well as your career, and you may bump your head a few times in order to learn and in order to understand how important that balance truly is. The Wheel of Fortune does signify the fact that with every up, there is also a down. Just as with a wheel, it depends on where you're standing on the wheel that dictates the perspective from which you're going to see life. So it is definitely essential for you to not judge yourself for the areas of your life in October where you feel like you're not as strong as usual, because from where you're standing in October, your love life is looking awesome and your love life is kind of taking all your attention and time, which is an amazing space to be in, because so many people wish they had such an interesting, spicy, fun love life. And you having the opportunity to just experience things that you will remember for a long time, romantic things in October, is an opportunity that you should take. Next, we have the High Priestess. So let's zoom in on the High Priestess. There we go. In the High Priestess, I can see here that when it comes to your personal beliefs, when it comes to your understanding of what another person wants spiritually as well, you're definitely very intuitive about that during the month of October, and you're definitely a lot more sensitive than you usually are. As an Aquarius baby, being sensitive or reading other people's emotions isn't always so easy for you. You're more of a very independent type of person, and you're a highly intellectual kind of person, but reading emotions, that is not your strongest suit. But I can see here that in October, it's almost like you've changed signs from an air sign to a water sign. I can see here within the Rado Crossite that you are truly remembering your worth as well, and remembering that work isn't everything. Despite what society tries to tell us about the importance of work, and work almost like defining how we feel about ourselves and how worthy that we feel, I can see that you are still keeping those two things very much separated. And this is something to be proud of and to feel like good about, okay? To feel good about being so mature and being so far removed from the peer pressure of allowing your work to define you, that means you like don't take opportunity of lots of great experiences that are coming for you romantically. It's really strong of you to stand up against any toxic work environments or any type of toxic work philosophies that are surrounding you. The Malachite does show me here that it's time for a big transformation in October for all my beautiful Aquarius babies. And this transformation has everything to do from being a workaholic to being like a loveaholic, being someone who just allows themselves to feel, to experience, and to be completely embedded in being emotional, not just being completely taken over by work and your commitments and to-do lists and creating new things, simply living in the moment and being mindful. That is all that you're about during the month of October. The Garnet shows me here that you are igniting your passions, and you're not allowing anyone to tell you otherwise or to tell you what to do. This is where, as an Aquarius, it comes really easily to you to just be independent and to just do what you want to do, because as an Aquarius, you are naturally a super independent and strong-willed type of individual. In the Unakite, I can see you living in the now. We literally just spoke about how you're very mindful in October, how you're very much living in the moment, and not allowing anyone to tell you to do otherwise, but simply going with what feels right for you and what honors the things that you love. And this is just amazing to receive within your reading, to see that you're stepping into your highest potential and that you're simply enjoying your life rather than overthinking work or overthinking any other commitments. Next up, we have the Page of Crystals reversed. The Page of Crystals reversed does show me here that you're having a good time with a fire sign. You're having a good time with someone who is young, someone who has really fun energy. And I can see here within the Three of Cups that rather than spending time, well, the Three of Cups reversed, rather than spending time at parties or with a lot of other people, you're just spending time with them in an intimate way, which we already spoke about in the Lovers and the Seven of Cups, that you're going to have a nice little intimate moment in October with someone, and you're just overall allowing for you to spend this one-on-one time with another human being and just enjoy it, just have a good time. The Six of Swords reverse shows me that you're not going to be doing too much talking, so I'm sure you can imagine what else that you may be doing, all my beautiful Aquarius babies. And this definitely, again, confirms the passion, it confirms the romantic aspect and not needing to speak in order to vibe with one another and to feel what you and the other person truly wants. Last but not least, in the Hierophant, I can see here that spiritually speaking, you are hyper aware of what other people are going through, and you are very respectful of other people's boundaries, especially energetically, and checking in with them about what they're going through, even while being physical or while being in a physical relationship with another person. You are always concerned to make sure that their boundaries are honored and respected, which is something that I just want to thank you for, my beautiful Aquarius babies. There are way too many people out there who don't check in with their partners, even if they're not in a committed relationship, who don't ensure that their partner feels comfortable in the way that they are being touched or spoken to. But you are definitely on the ball when it comes to that emotional well-being, understanding, and respect in October. So all of my beautiful Aquarius babies, this is the reading that I received for you for October. I really hope that you enjoyed this very special two-part approach to a horoscope. Let me know down below in the comment section by leaving a leaf emoji below to let me and your Aquarius brothers and sisters know that you were here. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Pisces babies, and welcome to your October zodiac signs prediction. So let's get straight into it so we can figure out exactly what your sign is going through during the month of October, shall we? So first up, we have the Ten of Coins. Wow, you're going through some financial, you're going through financial abundance, not difficulty, not hardship, no, financial abundance, all my beautiful Pisces. So I really hope that I didn't give you a little mini heart attack there, but do know here in the Ten of Coins that you're going through a lot of financial flow that is making you happy, that is making you a lot more relaxed, and that is allowing you to just chill because you don't have to worry about money. You don't have to worry about having enough time to make money. Things are just flowing effortlessly for you in the earthly realms. And as a result, your mental health is also looking up because you're not so worried and you are not constantly just overthinking situations about your finances and your career. Wow, the Ten of Cups. So emotional fulfillment is here as well. Could we start off October any better, all my beautiful Pisces babies? I sincerely do not think so. So far, your reading has been highly favorable. The Ten of Cups speaks of emotional fulfillment, deep love, nurturing, understanding, respectful love, that once in a lifetime kind of romance, and just overall happiness. So the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Coins, you are doing well in October, all my beautiful Pisces. Your reading is starting off in the most fabulous way. I can see here within the Three of Swords that everything going so amazingly well is definitely something that other people are noticing as well. And some people may actually even feel kind of jealous of this and ask themselves why everything is going so well for you, and they may become super nosy. The Eight of Wands here shows me that because everything is happening so quickly, it's very hard for you to properly register how fortunate that everything is around you and how well everything is going for you. So take some moments just to practice gratitude in October, all my beautiful Pisces babies. Take some moments to just look around and smell the roses, so to say. And as I can see here in the Two of Swords. Try to combat decision fatigue because everything is moving so quickly. You're definitely feeling as though you have to make choice after choice after choice and keep it pushing and continue to move forward. But you just enjoying the moment is just as important as pushing your life and your career further down the right path. The Seven of Cups shows me that a lot is just simply up to you to make the right choice during the month of October. And as we spoke about in the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Coins, you have made a lot of right choices. So don't overthink making the right choice or what type of ritual you need to go through in order to make the proper decisions or make decisions based on your intuition. It doesn't have to be a full moon, a new moon, a blue moon. You don't have to feel as though the humidity in the air is perfect in order for you to make intuitive decisions. You are an intuitive being by nature as a Pisces. You're sensitive, you're compassionate, you're someone who is very selfless as well as sympathetic. So trust in all of these positive attributes that you were naturally gifted with. In the Kent pumpkin, I can see a strong sense of need to be productive. So because you're on such a high in October, you want to keep it up, and that is definitely also causing a little bit of tension and a little bit of stress that isn't necessary. But I see here in the Dahlia that you can very quickly refine that to levels that are healthy and to levels where, of course, you're being productive and you're ensuring that you continue to have things look up for you, but at the same time, you are not so afraid of something going wrong that you're like a deer in headlights and that you're being stifled. No, there's like that perfect amount of productivity and at the same time being in the moment, mindfulness, enjoying your life. I can see here in the geranium that October is all about healing for you, my beautiful Pisces babies. It's all about finding your personal center, your personal equilibrium, and not feeling as though you're missing out on anything. Everything just going fabulously well, that I can see in the beetroot, you are able to work on passion projects because you're not super worried about your relationships or your finances. You can return back to your roots, back to your childlike sense of wonderment, and even pick up hobbies that you lost a long time ago or that you weren't able to do for a long time that maybe as a kid you were really passionate about. I know as a kid I used to love to sing and dance, even like in my teens and early 20s, and I kind of fell out of that a little more than I intended to, but I'm getting back into that and I'm getting back into passion projects, and that is definitely something that I can see you doing as well starting in October. Loosening your grip shows me here that rather than holding on very tightly to coping mechanisms that you once had, such as control, such as just putting in more work, having to be super, super productive in order to feel like you even deserve a break, you're loosening your grip and you're allowing yourself to simply just be in the moment and float around for some time as well. Earth pulsing, last but not least, all my beautiful Pisces, shows me here that you're slowing down. October for you is a time to be in nature. It's a time to slow down. It's a time to listen to the pulse of the mother, the pulse of the Pachamama, the pulse of the earth, and understand that we are all one. You are not separate from the earth, the galaxy, the universe. You are not separate from me or anyone else. We are all made up of the same beautiful stardust, and it's okay for you to just take a moment, smell the roses, and enjoy your epic October that's coming towards you. So all of my beautiful Pisces babies, this is your zodiac signs prediction for October. I hope that you enjoyed this two-part approach and that you found it insightful. Make sure that you leave a little pumpkin emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you made it all the way to the end of your prediction and that you enjoyed it. Feel free to leave any other comments below in the comment section as well. I love to read every single one of your comments. I would like to thank you once again for spending this divine time with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions.